Exodus chapter 15, verse 3. The Lord is a man of war. The Lord is his name. First and foremost, I want to give all praise, honor, and glory to the Heavenly Father and his only begotten Son, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakakwadash. Next, double honors to the head apostle slash elder bishop, the great millstone, the one that taught us the 100% truth according to the Bible. Peace, blessings, and safety to all you sincere Ikems. Keep pushing, keep believing, keep the faith. Regardless of people here, forbear the Lord, Yahweh is a man of war. Another lesson on just fearing the Lord. I'm on break. Something quick through the spirit of Yahweh, but Shemel Shai, just so knowing therefore the terror of the Lord, we persuade men. The Lord is going to send his only begotten Son back, who you ignorantly call Jesus, Yahweh Shai. He's going to send him back. He's going to wreck havoc. He's going to wreck shop. You know what I'm saying? He's going to wreck shop on you people, man. Once again, you thought he was a nice guy, right? That's how they depicted him in all these different movies. You see, just nice, smiling at everything. People wicked as hell. Oh yeah, he just smiling and everything. He look, he's angry with the wicked. Let's get that. Let's get that right quick. Let's just get it. Won't get it. Quick little lesson through the spirit. The Lord's getting ready to come and delete a whole lot of people, man. Y'all don't know that? Let's get this though. Psalm 7 and 11. Something quick through the spirit. Lord willing, the elect is edified. Lord willing, the elect of the nation of Israel. They're going to fear. Fear the Lord is a fearful thing, remember, to fall into the hands of the living. We're going to get that next too. Psalm 7 and 11, it reads, the Most High judges the righteous. And the Most High Yahweh, through his only begotten Son, Yahweh Shai, is angry with the wicked every day. Nobody didn't tell you that though, right? Because as long as Sleazy E is ruling the earth, he's going to let you do whatever you want to do. You see? Sleazy E don't give a damn if the Lord destroys you, Israel, that's for following after his nonsense. He don't care. But the Lord is angry with the wicked each and every day. Started out with Sleazy E. Esau, Edom, the wicked. According to the Bible, you could throw two turds in there. And these heathens, man. The Lord ain't sitting up there smiling at what y'all doing on the face of the earth. He's going to make a move on you. Psalms 7 and 11. Psalms chapter 7 verse 11. The Most High judges the righteous. And the Most High is angry with the wicked every day, man. Another reason why we should fear. Just a quick little lesson on just fearing the Lord. He's a man of war, man. He mustered the battle. He had the scientists create a weapon of his indignation, meaning the missiles, man. To consume flesh. To consume your flesh off your body while you stand upon your feet, man. Hebrews chapter 10. This is, like I said before, just quick. I'm on break. This is quick. A quick one, man. Hebrews 10, 31. It is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of a living power. Remember, he kills, he makes alive, he wounds, he heals. Neither is there any that can deliver out of his hand. People forget that. Like, you read a scripture like that to them, they walk down the street, that's they know. They start committing more wicked acts, man. Just not knowing that the Most High is angry with the wicked each and every day. Hebrews 10, 31. It is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living power. You see, the Lord said, go out there and give them warning from me. Give them warning from me. So when I bring that, when I bring destruction upon them, because that's exactly what the Lord bringing. When I bring that destruction on them, there won't be no excuse. Look, I don't want to hear the hooping. I don't want to hear the hollering. The Lord going to drop some of you Israelites and you heathens in hot boiling oil. You see? Going to set you on fire and everything. You see? He's a man of war. Let's get this. This is Jeremiah 25. It's a fearful thing, Israel. Jeremiah 25:33. The slaying of the Lord, the killing of the Lord shall be at that day from one end of the earth even until the other end of the earth. Remember, woe to you that desire the day of the Lord. You really want to meet him, huh? You really want to meet the king of terrors, right? You really do, huh? Really, yeah. Yeah, right. Jeremiah chapter 25, verse 33. And the slain of the Lord. Look up the word slain. That means killing of the Lord shall be at that day from one end of the earth even until the other end of the earth. dead bodies everywhere, man. They shall not be lamented. Ain't nobody gonna cry for you. Neither gathered nor buried. They shall be dung upon the ground. But this is the power that everybody's playing around with. This is an entity, a man of war. You playing around with a man of war that had the Smiths. Let's get it. Let's just get it. Let's just get it. Isaiah. A power that's coming back in a chariot the size of a mountain, but you playing around. You see, Isaiah 54. Isaiah 54 and 16, and it reads, "Behold, I have created the smith, the scientist that blew off the coals and the fire." The Lord gave the scientists, aka the smiths, the technology to split an atom, but you playing around with that, right? "And that bringeth forth in work, little, and that bringeth forth an instrument for his work. And I have created the waster to destroy." Once again, more reasons on why we should fear the Lord. All right? He had the Smiths, aka the scientists, create an ICBM missile, an intercontinental ballistic missile, the waster. The waster. You see? And he said he created it to destroy people, man. He created the ICBM missile to actually destroy people, man. You see? Let's get this, though. This is 2 Ezra chapter 16. Like I said before, just something quick. 2 Ezra chapter 16. Let's see. Just want to get this quick point. Let's see. Bear with me. This it. Verse 10. 2 Ezra 16 and 10. "He shall cast lightning on who shall not fear. He shall thunder on who shall not be afraid. The Lord shall threaten on who shall not be utterly beaten to powder at his presence." But you keep playing around. You keep playing around. Once again, "The Lord shall threaten, and who shall not be utterly beaten to powder at his presence," man. And I got all kinds of scriptures going through my head. I can't even think right about now. Remember, since I'm right here, I might as well bring this right quick, since I'm already here. Sirach chapter 11, I'm already here. Might as well bring this out right quick. Sirach chapter 11. "You will fear, yet your daughter, your hair, by Shem Yamashai." Sirach chapter 11, verse 14. "Prosperity and adversity, life and death, poverty and riches, come of the Lord. Come of the Lord." But these scriptures don't put no fear in you, right? It will though. Like I said before, a quick look hit through the Spirit. "Lord, one of the elect is edified. Fear. Let all of us fear. Let all of us fear." Let's get this, Jeremiah. And I'm just flowing in the Spirit. Whatever the Spirit feeds me, I'm going to feed you. Jeremiah chapter 10. Get him, Lord. Jeremiah chapter 10, verse 10. "But the Lord Yahweh is the true power. He is a living power, an everlasting king. At his wrath, Israel, the earth shall tremble." You ain't hear that though. "At his wrath, the earth shall tremble. And the nations shall not be able to abide his indignation," meaning his righteous anger, man. "If you only knew. If you evils and only evils." The Lord got us blowing a trumpet. The Lord got us blowing a trumpet. Joel chapter 1. Joel chapter 1. Just this verse right here. Joel chapter 1, verse 15. And it reads, "Alas, for the day of the Lord Yahweh is at hand, and as a destruction from the Almighty shall come." Remember, the slain of the Lord shall be from one end of the earth to the other end of the earth. Hey, have it your way. Look, have it your way, man. The Lord's going to come and destroy Babylon. Look, and though it tarry, wait for it. Matter of fact, let's just get this. Just want to get this right quick. St. Matthew, the 10th chapter. I'm going to throw this in here right quick. I'm going to just throw it in there. St. Matthew chapter 10. "Red letter, Lord Yahweh shall speak with a little called Jesus. St. Matthew chapter 10, 34. Think not that I am come to send peace on earth. I came not to send peace, but a sword. You see? More reasons why we should fear the Lord. Let's get this. Listen. Let's get Psalms. Throw Psalms in there right quick. We're just going to be all over the problem. Whatever the Spirit tells me to throw in there, I'm going to throw it in there. Lord say throw it in there, then throw it in there. Let's get this. Psalms 147. I'm going to just throw this in here right quick. Psalms 147 and 11. The Lord taketh pleasure, the Lord Yahweh, who you ignorantly call God, taketh pleasure in them that fear him, in those that hope in his mercy. And when the Lord start really putting a smackdown in this place, we pray, Abba, Ratazar, that we receive that mercy, man, that compassion, man, from the Lord. Once again, Psalms 147 and 11, the Lord taketh pleasure in them that fear him, in those that hope in his mercy. And let's get like one more, and I'm gone. Get one more, then I'm gone. Just want to do something quick. More reasons on why we should fear the Lord, right? Let's see here. Says the fear of the Lord. I want to get that. The fear of the Lord, that's the first step. Let's get that. Let's see. Bear with me. I'm just looking through them. Let's see. Bear with me. Let's see. There it is. That's what I want. Sirach, also known as Ecclesiastes chapter 19, verse 18. The fear of the Lord is the first step to be accepted of him. And wisdom obtaineth his love. See fear? See how important fear is? It's the beginning of wisdom. It's the beginning of knowledge. It's the beginning of understanding. More reasons why we should fear the Lord. Shalom.